Thank you. So I hope you can hear me well. Nice to see you here in this late afternoon. I know that you all are quite tired already. I also enjoy the conference really much, and this is the fourth day already. Let me start now. My name is Marco. I come from Positium. Positium is actually a company located in Tartu, and it's a spin-off company from University of Tartu. So Positium has been analyzing mobility data or location data about 20 years already. And of course, we have been using different kind of data sources, but one of the main has been mobile network operator data. So of course, you already may think that is it about tracking and so on. So I can just say for introduction also that we don't study the movements of individual people. It's rather understanding the movements of groups of people and so on. And today's presentation is specifically about kind of creating standard inside of Europe. Standard which all operators and statistical offices can follow, where all the privacy issues and technological issues are put into a single framework, so everybody who will see the results later can understand them the same way. Maybe just to start off with this example, why mobile network operator data? So after that, I will refer this to as MNO data. So mostly it has been widely used to understand the tourism, for example, roaming subscribers from other countries inside the domestic operator network, and also, for example, domestic or the local people going abroad, who went to Finland, who went to Latvia, for example. And also, it's good for understanding and planning traffic and public transportation. We have also quite good example from the same city here in Tartu, that mobile network data was one of the sources which were used in order to understand which bus stops actually matter. So the bus transit lines were shifted or rearranged later. Of course, you cannot never get this perfect transportation system, but still, this is one of the ways of understanding the hotspots of where the people are like moving or gathering. And of course, geographical distribution of the population. So this is, of course, a more deeper topic going into the census and these kind of things. There also this foundation is already there to use it in the future. And of course, crisis management, the rescue board, for example, wants to understand at a given point of time or some specific time slot, where are the people actually present or how many of them are in larger scale. We can also say that the mobile positioning data or the MNO data is not that precise. Of course, it's more precise inside of cities where there are more network towers, but of course it's less precise outside of urban areas maybe. Over these years, we have understood quite well that how difficult it has been to work with with different kind of operators all over the world, including Estonia. So they all have different systems, they all have different understanding of the how they extract the this kind of raw data to make it like appropriate for this kind of scripts that will make this meaningful indicators. And of course as well the maybe the statistical offices also have their own understanding, so we quite well know the pain, let's say. and this is a really good approach with this current project. And maybe just one thing to highlight also, the map on the right side showing Estonia is one of the good examples of this like commuting, for example. So it basically it doesn't show you precise locations where the people are moving, rather than the between the like municipalities, cities, and so on. And what we have also done with mobile data is that just maybe to have better understanding of, for example, how well or how much have been used local roads between different areas, you can just also try to merge it, for example, with road network layer, like just regular GIS component, the road data, and to understand what are the most probable roads which the people took. Okay, so moving forward, so basically, yeah, repeating the same things I was already telling is that to understand, to have the common understanding, to have the also the willingness from the MNO side, the operator side, to work with the statistical offices, because we GDPR exactly 6 years ago, this GDPR was applied in Europe, so a lot of new regulations came, and the mobile operators are not really happy or willing to give out or let the process the data, which is of course in some sense it's a correct thing from them to do, but on the other hand they have huge amount of this kind of passive sensor data, because all the mobile devices are actually like just sensors which could be used for the benefit or something which everybody could just have like better result, better urban this kind of environment or yeah, bus stops and these kind of things. The project is led by Eurostat, which is the European level statistical office basically. And we have several partners, COPPA consultation company is actually leading it, but for example, yeah, Positium along with Nommon is one of the, or two of the technical partners who are actually making this kind of framework and software like in real life, in happening, and so this software framework could be installed inside of the MNO's premises. And here we already see in the diagram that we have five mobile operators. We have Luxembourg Post, Slovenia A1, Vodafone Italy, Vodafone Spain, and also Orange Spain. So these are the five operators who have given the, or agreed, given the permission to participate in this project in a like active way. So all these kind of tests and the things we need to like validate, agree on, so on and so on, put in place. So all of these are happening inside of these five operators. As well as we have different kind of statistical offices and consultation partners Because basically after the data has been processed within the mobile operator network or the premises, the indicators, aggregated indicators, will later move to the like statistical departments, and this is another level of what will be happening with this data. And yeah, so maybe just to highlight the image on this next slide is that you can see that there are like many components which need to connect basically to make it happen and to have the data or the raw data put in a meaningful form to make any like conclusions out of it. One of them is yes, the legislation and privacy and these kind of things. And also partnerships with the mobile network operators, because it's not basically one-time project. It's meant to be something that will keep on running like constantly. Otherwise, it doesn't make any long-term meaning. And then at this point, we are focusing on this standard methodology. With this red circle. So, and then yes, the other parts are covered by other projects in this European system. Basically, what we are trying to achieve within this 2 years or a bit more than 2 years is to have the software at least to some extent or the framework put in place and also successful software processing on the operator premises and also to validate that if this kind of package of like consisting of methodology as and methodology and software is given to the operators, so they can also manage it without any specific background, with having like specialists, tens of specialists working on the same project, rather than giving the software and so they can successfully run it. And export these statistical indicators, and of course we are trying to cover like different use cases, like population and commuting, and also tourism and so on. And we were still hoping that it will after this project, this specific project within 5 or 6 years, it will be applied as an working kind of new framework and applied also by the European Commission level. And of course, we have many this kind of challenges to ensure the flexibility and adaptability and also how this all work together. So we are working in parallel with all of these, let's say, 12 kind of different topics. But all in all, by the end of the day, these are just overlapping in many cases. So yes, some of them are like, let's say, precaution or things that you can prepare, the things which are like processed and these are set, for example, the this kind of privacy issues and these kind of things. But of course, there are many things that will be ongoing, for example, this quality assurance, that because technology is changing, data will be changing in the future as well. Operators have really different kind of internal frameworks with these network frameworks and This is also, in many cases, will be something that needs to be taken care of in the future as well. And also, yes, the methodology and all these kind of things. Of course, methodology can be put in place, but we still hope to this to be something that will evolve in the future as well. So this is the like high level diagram, which basically means that we have MNO data on different level. We have this network data, which means that, for example, we have the network tower somewhere. It has geographical coordinates, and later this tower information will be applied to some kind of network event. We don't distinguish these network events like SMS call or whatever. We just have them as like in abstract way. Every event in a network will be we're getting the coordinates, and after that it could be located in some area. And yeah, so we basically work on different kind of data sets, like I mentioned, the MNO data itself. Also we have the contextual data, which could be, for example, country borders, city borders, these kind of things, different kind of reference data. And also it could be later merged to population data and these kind of things. And also we separately, of course, we have the configuration, which is important to understand what do you actually want to export from this kind of calculations. So here's just an example of the one of the ways to assign location to the network event. So some events may have coordinates like latitude, longitude, but usually these are just the coordinates of the cell tower, and every cell has its direction. It has the signal strength, and all these things are taken into account to place the people in some kind of geographical area. And of course, yes, like I mentioned, quality is really important. There are a lot of cleaning of the data because there are like missing columns, missing values, all these kind of things, which does not make any sense. You just have the package of noise, which doesn't make sense to be processed in terms of the because we are still talking about terabytes and terabytes of data, which needs to be processed. So, but of course, for this project, we are selecting probably a bit smaller areas, just to have the results faster. And but in long run we are looking at this kind of daily processing, so the activity of daily or daily events, and also like long term events. And also, yes, the modularity, which I spoke about. If new analyses are needed, we can just modularly add functions, operations. It won't affect any other things. We will have just an enrichment of different dimensions. And just to come back to this mid-term, long-term, is that yes, just to understanding of what happens inside of 1 day or 1 month or even the season, let's say four months, and also to understand what happens in 1 year or 2 years time. And by the end of the day, the data the indicators are also something that needs to be merged and used with other data sources. So, to make greater value out of them. Okay. Finishing up. To summarize, this project is about testing out or creating the framework and testing it out within a few operators who are willing to participate. And also just to stress more that everything regarding the privacy will have a really strong this kind of processing and agreements anyway, so because this is really sensitive topic and everybody are of course afraid of this kind of my data getting out there somewhere which I don't know about, but this is also which is being taken care of on a higher level, and once all of these things are put in place, so we hope that in few years or less than 5 or 6 years we would have successful this kind of framework which will work for and benefit everybody would benefit from it, like I said, as a better urban environment or something else. And if you have any specific interests, you can check out the project from this web page. I will put it back later. So thank you. So I'm finished.
Thank you very much for the presentation. Are there any questions?
Thank you. First, I would like to acknowledge that it's quite a difficult task, so congratulations, because we have been involved also in some MNO data, and I know from the experience that it's extremely difficult. The data we were getting, it's very heterogeneous. So for that, I was wondering if you are or you were involved also in the anonymization process, or you were getting the data already anonymized. So that's one question, because I have the feeling that it was treated quite differently by the providers, and at the end it was not so useful for our case, because it was like also with the missing data and that it was not homogeneous, it was very difficult. And then as a follow-up question, knowing how difficult it is and how heterogeneous it's also very how is your thoughts on other data that are not available to us, but that are in hands of like Google? They have much better data. It's not heterogeneous. They have all the data they need on, and they do whatever they want with their data to get to the analysis. So that's maybe a kind of an unfair battle to be able to work with data that is so. The quality is not so well. So a bit maybe your thoughts on that.
Okay, thank you. The first question. The data is anonymized on the operator side, so we don't have even access to this. So everything will happen on their side, and after that, data is being extracted. This kind of testing environment. But in most cases, the operators also will not let us access it, so it's totally on their hands. I personally have been in mobile operator offices months and days and weeks all over the world, waiting for the data and then just pointing with the finger sitting next to them. But usually, they don't. Which is, of course, a good thing from privacy side, that they don't allow any this kind of access unless all this anonymation and things are done. And in our project, the high probability is that all of these operations will happen only in their team or involvement, not even us. We will probably have to step out of the room after the testing, the system is up and running, they will take the real data and put it in. And just the follow-up question is, that these really giant technological systems have, of course, they have better understanding of us than we do, most probably. I don't even know if it's somewhere in discussion, but of course, I think in many cases people are wondering if this could be used. It's quite difficult to to put something or give something to them in order to get something back. So I don't know. It's definitely it's an unfair because the precision of mobile network data is definitely poor compared to this really precise GPS and location data, but at least with MNOs it's at least a starting point, because I don't know, the MNOs have been also there like 20-30 years already, so they're willing to actually participate. But this is Europe. We have to see what happens all over the world after that.
Any more questions? Yes.
Thank you for the interesting presentation. I myself had in previous life work on the data, so more or less I get some ideas on the challenges. I wanted to know, first, the technical question is, what is your data life cycle strategy looks like? You got the massive data, so how do you, get it ingested from the source? And then the second one is, are you guys doing batch or focus more on streaming processing, right? And then, I'll just give the rest for chance to ask questions.
Okay, thanks. Regarding this specific project, we will first maybe focus on a few months of data, but it will be batch at this point. However, in the future, so in order to have the daily, this kind of daily statistics running, we definitely would need to be ready for maybe not real time, but near real time operations as well. So it really depends on the capability of maybe the operators' framework, or the infrastructure and servers and everything, as well as just to methodology side, maybe just to understand what needs to be calculated like fast and what could be done later with the batch process. Maybe it takes more time, but it's more efficient not to maybe spend the resources at once so much.